Hello, dynamic students. Welcome to this video talking about how we map the velocity, both the linear and angular velocities, on all parts in a four-bar linkage using the instantaneous centers of zero velocity. Okay, so let's go ahead and start with adding a couple of those instantaneous centers that we can find here right away. Introducing this problem, we have a 75 millimeter member running from C over to B. That is in fixed axis rotation, of course, around point C, so we can go ahead and put an IC plus there. So just noting that this is the ICZV of member BC. That one should be obvious. Another obvious one coming over to the other side of the body is the ICZV at point O of body OA, right? Both of those bodies are in fixed axis rotation. So we could label this one the ICZV of body OA. All right, now getting into some linear velocities. Look at the absolute linear velocity here of point B. If we have an angular velocity, which is going positive from the right-hand rule, that's given in the problem in this case, our omega of CB, then it follows that our linear velocity here of point B must be vertical and going straight downward. Vertical because we know that the velocity is always perpendicular to that R vector from our equation V vector is equal to omega cross R, right? Our omega is positive from the right-hand rule, therefore our omega vector is coming out of the screen or out of the board. We're going to cross that vector into RB and end up with VB. Okay, so that's the basic velocity equation. I'll go ahead and leave that up there. Now, as we move over to point A, at this point in the problem, you may not know what direction left or right point A is moving, but you do know that it's going to occupy this line right here, right? Because that is the line that is perpendicular to my R vector coming from the fixed axis point O up to point A. Okay, so at this point in the problem, it is safe to just draw a dotted line and not actually put in that direction yet. Okay, now let's take a look at finding our ICZV of member AB, right? We found the other two. Let's find this third. You'll recall that if we have non-parallel velocities, and we can see here that for body AB, we have one velocity that's vertical, one that's horizontal, therefore those will not be parallel. And so we need to draw perpendicular lines from those velocities. So one of those will come across here. Now, another thing you'll notice is that if you have bodies in fixed axis rotation, it turns out that these extension lines perpendicular to velocities are going to be in line with the body of fixed axis rotation, right? I could extend this yellow line all the way back there to point C. Same thing here for the other body that I'll draw this one in blue. So here, starting at point O, I'll put a little squiggle to this one. Just my highlighter is not very wide in that direction. There is the line of perpendicular to the velocity at point A, right? Using that rule for non-parallel velocities. So it should be obvious that we have an intersection between these two lines right here. So this would be the ICZV of AB. All right, once we have that point, we know that this point acts like a fixed axis at this instant for body AB. And so AB is going to be rotating around this point, and we know VB is going down. Keep in mind the velocity of B on AB is exactly the same as the velocity of B on BC, right? These points of contact just reflect over or essentially have the exact same velocity at these points with forces. They're equal and opposite, both velocities and tangential accelerations. They're exactly the same at these contact points. And so as we look at that point there, we can see that in order for VB to go down, that we must have an omega of AB. Now I've kind of drawn over here around this fixed axis point. Now you could also draw it here on AB itself, omega of AB, in a negative right-hand rule direction, okay? So if we have a negative right-hand rule omega for AB, now coming back to our ICZV point of AB over here on the left side of our diagram, we then can figure out the direction of the velocity at point A, okay? So if we have negative right-hand rule crossed into a position vector. Now, the position vector we're talking about here is actually starting at the ICZV. Let me see, I'm going to have to put it in red so we can actually see it. Starting at the ICZV, and it's going up to point A. So this would be like my R of A relative to my ICZV of AB. Sorry, it's kind of a giant subscript there. But just looking at that position vector from, like I said, that ICZV up to point A, if we cross a negative omega into that position vector, we end up with the velocity coming here to the right. So this is my V sub A. Now that should generally make sense, right? It should generally make sense because we know that VB drops, and if the member AB can't get any longer, it can't get any shorter, that VA is going to have to come with it. It's going to have to go right as VB drops down. If VA wanted to go left and VB wanted to go down, AB would need to get longer and it would break. Okay, so there is only one option in these constrained motion systems. So hopefully that helps you as you're working on whether you're going to solve this problem with ICZVs or whether you're going to solve it with relative velocity and vector algebra, figuring out the unknowns in this problem. Speaking of the unknowns, commonly the unknowns could be this angular velocity omega AB. They also could be our angular velocity, I guess that's the last one I could add in here, is that my omega of OA we could also solve for because we know now the velocity there of A, so we could solve for this. We could also solve here for VA. We could additionally solve for VB. So it turns out you could actually solve for those four different unknowns simply starting with one known value, your omega of CB, and all of the geometry of this problem, right? That have to be given as well. So whether you're solving with ICZVs or relative velocity, this helps you map out these motion terms, and it should provide some reality to your computations, especially if you're doing this with vector algebra and you end up with all these different cross products, k-hats into i-hats and j-hats, and you're trying to make sense of those. This gives you the information that this VI is going in the positive i-hat direction. You know that VB is going in the negative j-hat direction. Now we're using an i-hat. I-hat is in the x direction, j-hat's in the y, k-hat is in the z direction. Omega AB here is going in the negative k hat, and omega of OA is also going in the negative k hat. So you can map out all those different velocities, at least their directions, without actually knowing any of the numbers. So this gives you some pre-conceptual understanding of how the system moves before you jump in to your numerical computations. Now, if you're going to solve this with ICZVs, instantaneous centers of zero velocity, then you would need to basically use this diagram, use this conceptual walkthrough that we did to determine the directions of these different linear and angular velocities, right? Because using that technique, it does give you the scalar values, but it does not give you the directions. So it is an integral part to solving with instantaneous centers of zero velocity. It is a great bonus to solving these problems with relative velocity and vector algebra because you can cross-check your cross products and cross-check the answers you're getting two different ways. I just about decided I was done on this video and I realized there's one more vector that I want to show you how we can find using this diagram. All right, so let's think about if we're going to use this kind of logical step through. You could use it for ICZVs. You could also use it for relative velocity doing your vector algebra. So let's say that we're going to solve velocity of A as a vector is equal to the velocity of B as a vector plus the velocity of A relative to B. Okay, so using vector algebra, I can set up that relative velocity equation. So we've fundamentally found VB. We have found VA. Let's go ahead and take a look at what this last term here looks like, VA relative to B. And in order to find this velocity vector here, I'm going to draw my associated R vector first, right? Remember that this term right here is equal to your omega of AB crossed with my R of A relative to B. All right, so I'm going to draw this R vector. I'm going to draw it in red just so we can see it over the top of this blue body. So I'm going to start that down here at point B and draw it up toward point A. So here's my R of A relative to B. So this becomes the basis to find my V of A relative to B. All right, so we have from the right-hand rule, this omega of AB is negative from the right-hand rule, right, wrapping around in this direction here. And so if I start with my fingers sliding down toward, either down toward your table or the screen, wherever your screen is, so into the screen, and then I curl my fingertips toward point A, I end up, so basically curling them this direction, I end up with the velocity is perpendicular coming out of point A up to the right. Okay, so here would be my velocity of A relative to B. Now, if I flip things around and say that you wrote your equation instead of this order here, that you wrote the velocity of B is equal to the velocity of A, plus my velocity of B relative to A. So that would cause me to write a position vector from A down to B. I'd use this exact same omega. So my omega is negative from the right-hand rule. So my fingers would go into the screen, curling now towards point B, and you could end up with a relative velocity here. This is your velocity of B relative to A. Okay, where both of these cases, this is perpendicular to AB, and they come from my omega of AB still now crossed into R of B relative to A. Keep in mind that these subscripts always match between your position vector and velocity vector. Hope that helps kind of fill in some gaps and fill in some understanding on the motion here of four bar linkages and really interconnected rigid body systems in general. Thanks for your time today.